Okay, so welcome everyone to the afternoon session. Our first speaker, Gerard Duchamp, will report on Klee stars and shuffle algebra.
Thank you, dear Gleb. I must first of all thank Maxime and the IATS team and my co-organizers Gleb Kochevoy and Hong Nok Min, and of course you all for attending this talk. And I will speak about Klee stars and shuffle algebras. Why a tangle tail? Because you will see that when you begin to calculate within non-commutative series, you have to manage with superpositions. And this is a notion we made clear with Gleb Kochevoy and Christophe Tolu in our publication in Lotharingien, Twisting and Perturbations. And we will speak mainly about perturbations and its combinatorics. So now what is the goal of this talk? We have three goals today. First, I will take some time for motivation, explain how this is motivated and what is the route from the very first motivation that was to extend the polylogarithm and to some mat overflow post. Which made the collaboration with Darish Greenberg possible. And after, we will cite the main theorem, and it is a general theorem. We have two proofs, but maybe due to lack of time, I will not go into detail. But this result is take place into three variations of a general theme, which is the linear independence of character on coalgebras. And this is the subject of our publication. So we will see. This is generality. But we will go into details. This is more or less generality because it is done on enveloping algebras. The main result will be in generality, and it has been discussed. The condition has been discussed, and after we will see also examples. And examples are made mainly on by algebras formed from the free algebra by adding some co-multiplication. And after, we will end with some remarks about the structure of Hausdorff groups. Hausdorff groups, this term is inherited from Bourbaki. It is the group of group-like. Bourbaki calls Hausdorff groups a group of primitive series. So this will be the group of characters, more general than group likes, in this context, and we will see how we can devise a local system of coordinates and have some identities that cannot, in my opinion, be proved otherwise. Of course, parts of this work rest on iterated integral, so it is linked with Dyson series. Now, we go to the initial motivation. The initial motivation is from hyperlogarithm. You have in the complex plane, you take points, different points, all different singular, which will be seen as singularities, A1, A2, AN, And you see that the functions that are integrated, it is 1 over z minus aj, are all holomorphic within the plane without this point. Of course, you have as you have a monodromy phenomenon, you must base yourself on the path. So if you take a list of singularities, possibly with repetitions. All singularities are different, but your list can be with repetitions and a path, avoiding all singularities from Z0 to Z, and you form this. Of course, you see that this quantity does depend on the path, but it does not depend on the, it does depend only on the homotopy class, meaning that if you take two paths that are homotopic, of course, the result is the same. As the result depends on the homotopy class, it can be seen as a function on the universal covering, or you can work, sometimes it is easier, on the cleft plane, which is a section of this universal covering. You take the singularities and you take a direction from which the singularities are seen different, and you take half rays in order to avoid the logarithm phenomenon, which consists in turning around one singularity. So now, how do we change this with our concern today? The set, these functions take a list of singularities and a path. As we have said, we work on a simply connected domain, so only the extremal point of the path count, the initial point, and the base point and the end point. And we will shift from a list of singularities to words, because we said that to each singularity we have attributed a letter. So now you have a word. So you have here, you have done a mapping which take an end point. I will make this clear here, because your base point is given once for all, and it takes the endpoint and a word. So now it depends only on a word with variable coefficients. So this is a series, which is the generating series of all your computations, of your computations that you can imagine, taking a word and as monomial, and it is a non-commutative generating series of your hyperlogarithm. Now, why do we take this generating series? Because it has a lot of nice features. It is a solution of non-commutative differential equation with left multiplier. I will not go back to this because I went many, many times here and elsewhere since 2017 in CAP 17, CAP 18, and CAP 19 on the study of this series. And the left multiplier will be proved as primitive. And as you know, if you have a Hausdorff group, it is a sort of Lie group with Lie algebra, the primitive series. So we can prove, as this left multiplier belongs to the Lie algebra of our group, as in at one point, which is Z0, it is group-like. It can be said to be group-like on all for all Z, and it is a shuffle morphism. We have seen also the second feature, which is linear independence of the coordinates. With respect to C, it is not difficult to prove this with the monodromy, but it can be seen to be independent of larger sets of scalars, larger rings, or larger even fields of functions, which will not be the subject of today. But if you go to the slides of CAP 19, you will see this study. And which will be our concern today, it will be at the end of this talk, will be the factorization of this character in elementary characters. And once this series is factorized, you can delete, because you see that when you approach the singularities, you have you can have some divergences. So you can renormalize by deleting some factors of this factorization. See, which is this point. And we will see at once what is the problem of extension to some series, because you see that here your quantity depends on a word. So you can linearize this mapping and say, oh, it depends on non-commutative polynomials. But what will it be if you, instead of a word or a polynomial, you put inside a series, an infinite sum? So you cannot put every infinite sum, avoiding the divergences. You have to put infinite sums that are in its domain. We will see at once what will contain the domain. And in particular, this domain contains easy to compute with series. And these series are expressed in a very, very useful language, very easy to compute in language, which is linked to automata theory. And this is a clean star. Clean star, if you take a series without constant term, you can take the series 1 plus s plus s squared plus until infinity, and it is 1 minus s inverse for respect to the concatenation in the algebra of non-commutative series. So now it is a detail, but the Dapo-Dalilyevsky was reading on from left to right, and we are reading from right to left. And of course, it is to match with a more recent bibliography. Now, what do we have? We have done the hyperlogarithm. I recall that hyperlogarithm takes you a word or a non-commutative polynomial, and it gives you it gives you an holomorphism function. So we have evoked argument of the proof such that this hyperlogarithm, which takes a word and then a non-commutative polynomial, is a shuffle morphism. If you put in as an argument the shuffle of two polynomials, you get the product of these two hyperlogarithms. And how to extend this? We have here a space, which is a space of formal power series. For these spaces, we like to decompose a series into a homogeneous slice, which is the sum of all coefficients for all words with the same length n. And as our alphabet is finite, the number of singularities is finite, this Sn is a polynomial. So you can substitute this Sn into hyperlogarithm. Now you have to consider, as in your source, you have your series that can be like that. It is just not other than the sum of its homogeneous components. You have to consider this series in the target. So this series is in the target may not converge. So we ask that it converge unconditionally, means in French they say convergence commutative, and sometimes in the Anglo-Saxon world say commutatively convergent, and unconditionally means it converges whatever the terms are. And if it converges whatever the terms are for the compact convergence, which is convergence on every uniform convergence on every compact, it is a standard topology on H of omega in order to preserve analyticity. We say that this series is admissible as an argument of HL if and only if this series is unconditionally convergent. And this is why we ask this. It is because H of omega shares with the finite dimensional topological vector spaces. We are on C here. The nice property that if a series is unconditionally convergent for this compact convergent, then it is absolutely convergent. And we need this to prove that the shuffle property is preserved in the new domain. So now you have your polynomials, you have your holomorphic functions. It is, of course, a subspace of all holomorphic functions in omega. And you can extend this to series which are members of the domain. The domain is then, as we said, the series, such that if you decompose the series as in is homogeneous components, this series converges commutatively. Now, so if the main result is if you take two series in the domain, their shuffle is in the domain. Of course, one is in the domain. So you have extended this into the domain such that the shuffle property is preserved, and it is a character with values in H of omega with values in a commutative algebra. So now, as we want to give examples, we take the polylogarithm. The polylogarithm is a special case of hyperlogarithm with some asymptotic condition. I don't go into detail. Say, please admit that it is a special case of hyperlogarithm. So it is the same as it was for hyperlogarithm. The domain is the set of series such that if you decompose the series, then this series converges unconditionally. And now, what can you substitute? You can substitute as motivation of our title, clean star. Each time you take an expression or a series, and you check that it is without constant term, the clean star of it is just this. So what will it be here? You take x0, you have two singularities which are 0 and 1 in this example instead of a1, a2, an. And you have x0 and x1, the letters indicating to which around which singularity you integrate. And x0 star is just 1 plus x0 squared, but it's x0 cubed, and so on. And this you can prove, of course, it is an easy exercise, that it is in the domain. X1 star is in the domain, and you get these values when you compute, and which will be seen here. And it is why it is called star of the plane, because you have x0, x1, which are two independent letters, the two-dimensional space alpha x0 plus beta x1 is a plane, and star of the plane is exactly these guys. And these guys, we will see how they can be seen as characters. And it can be proved, maybe I think, yes, it can be proved that if you consider alpha x0 and beta x1 in the previous slide, you have the general formula is this one. It is the star of alpha x plus beta, alpha x0 plus beta x1. So as it is, can be decomposed. And as this guy can be seen as alpha x0 star shuffle beta x1 star, the LE of this is not other than this the product of the LE. And one can prove, and it is a lot of easy computations. If you put alpha here, you have z to the alpha. If you put here, you have z to minus beta. So it is a product formula which was seen here. Now we go to the next. It will be more and more algebraic. So first motivation was analytic, but it will be more and more algebraic. Every Kong character is of this form. Of course, you have only one character due to the fact that we are in the free algebra. You have only one character to such that to each letter you may correspond alpha of x. But it is an easy but not immediate exercise to prove that it is the star of this linear combination. And now you have shuffles with perturbations. As after the word, we call them with Gleb Cochevoy and Christophe Tolu, it is a perturbation of the shuffle product. The shuffle product is only based on this recursion with the same unit, and if you can perturbate it with the phi, it takes two letters. You can be linearize it, and from this quality of this operation defined, you can prove that it's associative or commutative, and so on. So you have the shuffle with no perturbation, the shuffle with the perturbation, which is given the addition of indices, the twill filtration, which gives a bi-algebra, which is not enveloping algebra. These two give enveloping algebras, but this gives bi-algebra, which is not enveloping algebra. Due to the time lack of time, I will not go into detail for Hadamard. And this is a table of shuffle product that we see in in the literature, beginning with Rhee and Hoffman, and Costermans, who is a student of Min. Hilbert and Min considered Raffle for their computations. These two were considered in order to filter the superposition terms of the Staffel. And as was evoked, we said that we considered twistings and perturbations. And here it is a non-twist expression, and you have this perturbation, and this is the term which is added. I pass the others, save the one with Manchon, maybe, who considered the generality with a perturbation, which is a law of algebra associative with unit, and it can be non-commutative, and then the phi shuffle associated with this is not commutative. So the common pattern is the following. You have the beginning of the recursion of a shuffle with perturbation. Now, what is the initial motivation? It is a post I cast on Math Overflow. And of course, this post is what is written in clear here. And it is the following. You take Lie algebra over a ring without zero divisors. It has been discussed that this condition is important for the conclusion. And you take the enveloping algebra, and you consider the standard decreasing filtration, which is just the product of the term in the augmentation ideal. Now, you have this filtration, which is decreasing. You take the orthogonal filtration with a little shift of index. And this is in the dual of this enveloping algebra. And you can show that this filtration is a filtration of convolution with respect to convolution. So as it is increasing, and the filtration with respect to convolution, the union of all the sectors is a convolution subalgebra of U star. It is not, in general, in the polynomial examples, it is not all dual. So we see that you have a commutative, as was said. So I pass this, or maybe not. This is a way given to us by Gleb Koshevoy, which is very nice, how to compute the phi shuffle. You take your two words. The first word, you put it vertically. The second word, you put it horizontally from left to right. And you allow from this leftmost low corner to this rightmost upper corner, you allow passes with east, north pass, and diagonal pass. And to each pass, you can evaluate each pass as a term. For example, if you have a diagonal term, I will take phi of the two letters. And if I have a horizontal pass, I put the letter in the word, the horizontal word. If I have a north step, I will put a letter of the vertical word. So now I can, this is another example. I pass this, which is Radford theorem. I pass was it is a dualizability here. So we have considered a phi shuffle, and we can say that k of x with this phi shuffle, providing that phi be associative, is a associative algebra. And one can prove that due to the recursion, if you endow this algebra with a coproduct, which is a D concatenation, which is dual to concatenation, an epsilon, which takes a constant term of every polynomial, you have a B algebra. In fact, due to the fact that this delta is nilpotent, the delta plus, you take delta plus and you repeat this procedure. Due to the fact that this delta is nilpotent, then this algebra is in fact a Hopf algebra, because you can compute the inverse of the identity, because you can put identity equals epsilon plus I plus, and then you compute the inverse with the usual series. Now, you want to go to the dual. So if you want to go to the dual, your deconcatenation will take the place of a concatenation, and your phi shuffle will take the place of a delta phi shuffle. So you have a technical condition on the structure constants in order to guarantee this. I will not develop, but the slides are available on the site. What is interesting? What is interesting is that if you have a phi shuffle, the characters on this algebra are stars of the plane, which means that you take a linear combination of the letters. If your alphabet is infinite, this linear combination can be infinite. It's just a linear form, and you put a star on it. It is star of the plane. And as you know, in every B algebra, the characters of the algebra itself compose with respect to the dual law of the delta. So you compose these stars of the plane with the phi shuffle itself. And this is not so easy to prove combinatorially. In a pedestrian way, but if you take into account the fact that the phi shuffle of two characters is again a character, you just have to test this formula on letters, and you can prove that this follows the recursion. Means that if you have this, as you have firstly, the first term, the second term, and the perturbation, and you have an identity which can serve to analyze groups, Hausdorff groups of Staffel, for example, which are not so free. And this is now our main result with Darish Greenberg and Hong Nokmin. It means that this property holds for every bi algebra, but in enveloping algebra, the monoid of character in is a group. Here, for a bi algebra, you have only a monoid of character, so we have to take this into account. So we start with a bi algebra, and we make the standard decreasing filtration as was the case for enveloping algebras. I take the orthogonal filtration, which is increasing. With no surprise, it is a filtration which is compatible with a convolution product. And the conclusion is the set, if this can be done on whatever the ring of coefficients, but now you have to take an integral domain, and for an integral domain, this group of characters is linearly independent with respect to this convolution algebra. So, as an example, I can give an example which is with only an univariate polynomial. So you take the B-algebra, and the algebra itself is the algebra of polynomials. You take only one variable. Delta is delta of x is x tensor 1 plus 1 tensor x, means that x is done primitive, and epsilon is to take the constant term of polynomials. So as a not clean stars of the plane, it is clean stars of the line, because you have only one dimension here. So the characters are of this form. So it is easily checked that you have this. It is a particular case of the formula that was given previously. And the monoid is isomorphic to the abelian group. In particular, it is a group, but it is a case for every enveloping algebra. And this is an enveloping algebra. And now let us give a non-trivial example. You take the algebraic measure of the rational. In order to have the roots, you could take also the extension of Q by the roots. And you take all the prime numbers. And you take these roots of the prime numbers. And this is a character of K of X. This is not difficult, but now what the preceding study shows that this set of characters is algebraically independent over the polynomials. And you can double check this, considering that this is this formula. The star is the inverse of 1 minus the square root of Pn x. This time with respect to the concatenation product, and you have to use this, means that the shuffle power goes into the multiplicator of the character. So you can double check that it is algebraically independent. Of course, if you use many variables, you have non-trivial results. So what we consider now is the group of characters. And the group of characters, you have exponentials and the logarithm. It is, you have a very very easy log x correspondence. Now I will dive into, I will swoop into the example of the Staffel product. The Staffel product, as was explained here, uses the addition of indices as perturbation. So you have the beginning is the same as the Staffel, and you have y index I plus j, this term. Now, if you take an application of our formula, which is general here, for Staffel, you have this. You have this star, Staffel this star equals this plus this. I could have put only the one index and alpha I plus beta I, and this is the bilinear product, and this is the phi. So see, if you see this formula, you can immediately imagine that if you take as a mental image your yi as a power, like in Humboldt style, so you code this linear combination by this series, means that you take the index and you put it as a power, you get the following from 11, you get the following formula. we will call phi umbra y this coding, and then you have phi umbra y of s, shuffle, phi umbra 1 of t, star, and the shuffle is here, equal phi umbra y of 1 plus s, 1 plus t, minus 1. So this will result in the fact that this is a one parameter group. And as it is a one parameter group, we can have identities which can double check by Newton-Girard formula. This is a star of the plane, so it is a character. And a character is also an exponential of primitive element. So the question is, we have a character, so it is the exponential of what? It is the same as it is. So taking our coding, we can use this and take one letter, for example, renormalized by t, and say that this is of course not a one parameter group, it is a one parameter path drawn on the Hausdorff group, but it can be log, one can take the log of this one parameter path and have this formula. So this formula can be double checked by other means. Maybe. So let me conclude. Star of the plane property, which is not difficult, but it is worth to be, means that in this by algebra, which are of use combinatorially for many operations of on formal power series, coding different things. Star of the plane property means that a character of this is exactly of this form. So this formula eases the computation on the group of character. And for conc characters, you can have matrix-valued characters or non-commutative-valued characters. It is not important because the free algebra is the algebra of non-commutative polynomials. Now, if you consider this, the composition of these characters, you have an evolution equation. That's why it is so linked to the project evolution equation in physics led by Carol Penson. Now, if you have a character which is this time A valued, means that A is a K commutative algebra associative with unit. Contrary-wise to the one, you must have a commutative. Well, it is not important so that, because as this is commutative, then the image is commutative. But we will, you see that if you phi deform this, it is not necessarily commutative. So you must, we must start with this. And this character will be taken as identity. You give me a word, I give you that word, the same word. It is identity. And of course, it has a shuffle property because it is a shuffle morphism. So now you have, this is what we call the diagonal series. It is the sum on all words that W, tensor W. And you see that it is an expression of identity, so you can change the terms from W and W to two a basis in duality, two orthogonal bases, orthogonal between themselves. So it can be proved it is a MRS factorization from Melançon, Rottenover, and Schützenberger, that this is the product of this exponential. Of course, now if you change the character, you can keep the identity between the diagonal series, which is a formal identity, and this. And then you obtain a system of local coordinates. I said that the Hausdorff group was a sort of Lie group. So you know that if you take a basis of the Lie algebra of a Lie group, you and take the exponentials, you have a system of local coordinates at the neighborhood of the unity. Now, you see that this will give you a system of local coordinates of your Hausdorff group by decomposing every character as a product of elementary characters. And to end with, you have a deformed version of this factorization. And of course, it is rather straightforward if phi is associative and commutative. But I don't know yet if it is generalizable and under which condition it is generalizable to a non-commutative perturbated shuffles. We have to explore this. So this factorization, which is easy to set and to state in the case of shuffles, in fact holds for all enveloping algebras which are free as a K-module. Because of the Poincaré-Birkhoff formula, you can derive a formula Poincaré-Birkhoff basis, and under certain conditions, technical conditions, you can have the orthogonal basis, which is in this B star convolution algebra. So this can be set in on every enveloping algebra. So we have evoked two or three times in our conversations with Gleb Kochevoy that we could use this to factorize some characters on other enveloping algebras like Knisnis, Zamolochikov, pardon me for the pronunciation, Lie algebra, and otherwise, other ones, we were evoking another Lie algebra, which was commutative and coming from Maxim. So now I have said, I have finished with my presentation, and thank you for, of course, your attention. With many bubbles.
Thank you, Gerard. So we have 1 minute for question before Min talks.
Yes.
Yes. Are there questions?
Or remarks or comments? Even. No.
Even. Thank Gerard.
Thank you, Gleb, and thanks for your attention to the public.